गुड मॉर्निंग 8th क्लास, वी आर बिगनिंग विद 7th चैप्टर. दिस इज़ द लास्ट चैप्टर ऑफ रिवाइज सिलेबस फॉर दिस टर्म. दिस इज नर्वस सिस्टम. सी, लिविंग ऑर्गेनिज्म रिस्पॉन्ड एंड रिएक्ट टू वेरियस टाइप्स ऑफ स्टिमुली विद द हेल्प ऑफ नर्वस सिस्टम. नर्वस सिस्टम, इट इंक्लूड्स ब्रेन, स्पाइनल कॉर्ड एंड नर्व्स विच रिसीव इंफॉर्मेशन फ्रॉम द सराउंडिंग्स, प्रोसेसेस इट एंड इंटरप्रेट्स इट अकॉर्डिंगली. So nervous system also passes information from one internal system to another, thus controlling and coordinating many functions in the body. Earlier this chapter was taught along with endocrine system together, because both are controlling and coordinating the various organelles. So now they have separated this. Now learning new words, one is cerebrum, cerebellum, reflex action, neuron and stimulus. These terms you need to learn. Cerebrum is the part of brain which acts control center of the body. Cerebellum, it is again a part of brain which controls and coordinates skeletal muscles that are voluntary muscles and maintains the balance of the body. Then reflex action, the automatic response by a body towards the stimulus, that is called as, this is automatic, okay, towards the stimulus. Then neuron is the structural and functional unit of nervous system. As you know, structural and functional unit of body, the organism, is cell. Neuron is same way for nervous system. Then a stimulus, any agent in the environment that may cause an organism to respond, that is called as stimulus. So in all higher animals, the changes in the environment known as stimuli are received by specialized sensory cells called receptors or sense organs, and they show reaction to such a stimulus, which is known as response. So stimulus will be received by sense organs and reaction is occurred, that is called as response. So for doing this all, nervous system is required. Nervous system coordination. Fundamental functions of nervous system are as follows. First one, reception of the stimulus. It helps us to gather information about the changes in our surroundings. In multicellular organism, this is done by modified nerve cells, which are called as receptors. Then conversion of a stimulus. The stimuli is converted in the form of electrical impulse, that is called as, that process is called as transduction. Then that impulse would be transmitted, that is called as, this is possible through sense organs, eyes, ear, nose, tongue and skin. So transmission of a stimulus. Then interpretation and analysis of the stimulus. It enables us to think, reason and store information. This is fourth part. Then fifth is response by an effector, that it controls and balances various voluntary muscles action. It also controls and coordinates involuntary, not according to will, activities such as digestion of food, beating of heart, respiratory movements and so on. So this is response by effector. So these are nervous system coordination, fundamental functions of nervous system. Five they have given, you need to learn. Then come to nervous tissue. To carry out the above functions, the system consists of structurally and functionally specialized tissues known as nervous tissue. That is made up of nerve cells or neuron and packing cells. They are called as neuroglia. Brain, spinal cord and nerves connected to the brain and spinal cord contain nerve cells. What is neuron? That is, a cell is specialized to conduct electrochemical impulses called nerve impulse or action potential.